The Dark Island, the final episode in Robert Barr's story of espionage in the remote islands of the Outer Hebrides. In his search for the elusive group who were operating an escape route from the Dark Island, Bill Grant had taken two steps on his own. He's planted a fake passport in a bedroom at the hotel, with no immediate result. Later, near the harbor, he'd seen a man whom he recognized and gone in search of him. That night, Ian McLeod finds Grant in his hotel bedroom, dead. Jim Nicholson has discharged himself from hospital just in time to hear the news.
That's how Ian found him, sir. In the chair, and the passport lying on the bed.
You say his revolver was also on the bed, but that it hadn't been fired.
Here it is.
Mr. McLeod, you say he'd planted this passport on someone the night before.
Aye, Major, he did, yes. I waited in his room while he did it.
I think Grant was disappointed there'd been no immediate reaction to the plant. There's no doubt it caused his death.
Poor devil. Well, what have you done so far?
Well, Ian very sensibly locked his room at the outset. I've left it locked and told Macaulay, the manager, that he's ill and mustn't on any account be disturbed.
You can scarcely keep the room locked much longer.
No. I've warned Dr. McKenzie. When it's quiet at the hotel, we can have him taken out on a stretcher and brought here by ambulance.
Yes, that seems best. Did you know that the Russian sailor had gone?
My driver thought he saw him down by the shore last night. What happened?
Well, very few people knew he was in the camp. And also, it seems that he speaks very good English.
Does he? Good God.
After he'd managed to get out, he walked down to the gate and chatted the corporal. In English, cool as a cucumber. Well, the corporal mistook him for an islander.
So what happened?
Well, the sailor said he'd been in the camp to see me, then he simply walked out. It was just getting dark.
But if he speaks good English, he must have been left on the island to make arrangements.
Yes, it looks like it now. By the by, I have a call through to London. Is there anything else you can tell me? Has this Dr. Lawrence arrived?
Apparently, yes. The hotel manager told Ian McLeod last night.
Anyone seen him?
No. Well, Grant saw someone near the harbour he recognised. That might have been Lawrence.
Unlikely. I don't think Grant knew him.
Brigadier on the line, sir.
Oh, thank you, Wilcox.
I'll see Dr. McKenzie then, sir, and take him to the hotel.
Right, Jim. Goodbye, Mr. McLeod.
Goodbye, Major.
Morning, sir. William speaking.
Morning, Williams.
I've bad news, I'm afraid.
Oh?
Captain Grant has been killed.
Good God. When was this?
Last night, sir. It had to do with the passport. He planted it, put it in one of the bedrooms. When he was shot, the passport was found beside him.
Have you any idea who was responsible?
No, sir. Now, I was with you in London yesterday, and after I came back, Captain Grant wasn't in contact. Another thing, the young sailor from the trawler... escaped last night.
Was this before Grant was killed?
Yes, sir.
Any newcomers to the island?
Yes, sir. Dr. Lawrence has arrived. And we have information that Captain Grant saw someone he knew down by the harbour. He went off to speak to him. Nicholson was wondering if it could have been Lawrence, sir.
No, Grant wouldn't have made contact with Lawrence. If he was prepared to speak to a newcomer, it must have been someone else. Someone he had no cause to suspect.
I see.
This intrigues me. I'd better be with you, I think.
Oh, good, sir.
I'll fly up this morning. And Williams...
Yes, sir?
I want you to lay on a force to go to that island tonight, to Dorica. Do it quietly. Choose 24 of your best men, armed, and 2 boats. And wait till I arrive.
Yes, sir.
He's running a temperature, Mr. McCauley, and he said you wanted the room.
But I wouldn't put out a sick man.
Well, the doctor wants him in hospital.
If the doctor wants it that way.
The new guest has arrived, then?
Dr. Lawrence, aye. He booked in yesterday. But he didn't come back last night. He said he had friends to visit.
Did he?
Aye. Well, that's the ambulance away. Will you excuse me, Mr. Nicholson?
Of course. Oh, Ian, I want you to go over everything Bill Grant did yesterday. Everything he said to you.
Well, he didn't say very much. And I've told you what we did. We went to this other signal post in Dorica. He searched it. He said it was much the same as the one you found. And he spotted that old Croft house. You know, the one we saw the first time we went there, just behind the beach?
Oh, yes, I remember. Well, I should do. We were just about to be shot at.
Well, we took a look in it. It was empty, and then we came back across the island, over to here, and, we left him to come down to the hotel.
Oh. Did you see him again?
No, I never saw him again. Alive.
When you were with him, did he talk about meeting a friend or expecting one?
No.
About the passport, have you really no idea which room he went to?
No, I have not. But I think maybe it was Swanson's.
Bill was armed, Ian. He was in his own room. And from his position in the chair, he could see the door. Yet there was someone in the room with him. Someone he let get close to him and behind him. That wasn't Swanson.
Someone he trusted.
Mm.
Miss Summers?
No, I don't think so. He was taking her over to the island that night. If she was involved, it could have been done there. No, it must have been someone else. Come out with me to the phone box and keep an eye open in case Swanson comes back. Ah, Mr. Macaulay.
Aye, Mr. Nicholson.
Is Mr. Swanson in?
No, he's not long gone out.
Has Dr. Lawrence come back?
No, he hasn't been back at all. Mr. Swanson asked the same thing and then went out to meet him, I believe.
Mr. Swanson?
Yes. Let me in, please. You are Dr. Lawrence?
Yes.
Can you identify yourself?
Yes, I was to show you this.
Good. Good. I've been expecting you for 3 days, Dr. Lawrence. There is nothing to worry about. We have one of the men from the trawlers ashore. Everything will go very smoothly. Now, there are some things you must have. A life jacket in case there's any trouble on our way to the island.
What island?
One further west. A shorter journey to the trawlers. They'll send a longboat for you.
Oh, I see.
And here is money. You'll put that in your bag.
What sort of money is this?
You are going to Riga. There you will be met. Now, your passport. Do you have the photographs?
Yes. Here they are.
They are very good. And now I have to fix the photograph and the stamp and fill in your passport. It will take a little time.
The Brigadier has arrived, sir.
Ah. Oh, good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon, Williams. What's happened about Captain Grant?
His body's in the camp, sir. Do you wish to see it?
No, not yet. Later. Where's Captain Nicholson?
He's outside with Miss McLeod. For intelligence duties, sir, he passes as Mr. Nicholson.
For this operation, he must assume his rank or he'll be in trouble. He's Captain Nicholson.
Yes, sir.
Bring them in, then.
Captain Nicholson? Miss McLeod?
Ah, Nicholson. We meet at last.
Good afternoon, sir. May I introduce Ian McLeod?
I'm very pleased to meet you, Mr. McLeod, and to thank you for all your help.
Oh, not at all.
How's your arm, Nicholson?
Oh, it's mending, sir.
Good. Now, gentlemen, it is my opinion that Captain Grant was killed because of a leakage of our plans. And that leak may be within our own department. If Grant recognized his murderer, then that is so. Keep that fact uppermost in your minds. I've taken certain steps to deal with this dangerous possibility. One of them is that we strike tonight. Quickly, quietly, and in strength. Because we are faced with a very carefully planned operation. Major Williams, have you chosen your men?
Yes, sir, plus a sergeant and a corporal.
Good. Two boats?
Yes, sir.
Let me see the chart. Nicholson?
Yes, sir. This is the first signal post we found. Just here, sir.
Hmm. That was where you got shot, eh?
That's it, sir. And here's the second post. It was examined by Bill Grant and Mr. McLeod. It's to the end of the island on which the container should have beached, Dorica, the Dark Island. And there's an old deserted house back some distance from the beach about here, sir. Captain Grant and Mr. MacLeod inspected it yesterday.
Mr. MacLeod?
It's the old Morrison Croft, sir. I've been away from there, 6 or 7 years.
Any other buildings on the island?
No. No one lives there at all, no.
Hmm. Where do these trawlers usually lie?
Out here, sir.
The signal posts have been left intact?
Yes, sir.
Then all is set. We must allow their operation to proceed. So we must move in darkness. We must be well prepared and know what we are about. Major Williams, I want 2 good men, not from your party, 2 extra men, to watch the southern signal post tonight. If there are signals, they're not to interfere. They just watch and take the signal a prisoner on radio instructions.
Yes, sir.
The other points are all on this island, Dorica. We'll have to land there in force in darkness.
If you'll excuse me, sir, we'll have to make this area in daylight and tie up. And then we can push across this channel when the light has gone.
Thank you, Mr. MacLeod. That looks quite secure. Major Williams, you, Nicholson, and Mr. MacLeod will take 1 boat and 20 men. You will land here. 1 party under your command will make a sweep of the island to ensure that no one leaves it. I want sentries posted.
Sir?
The other party under your command, Nicholson, will surround the signal post and... Captain Grant brought the miniature radios up with him, didn't he?
Yes.
Nicholson, you will take one. There's a photo reconnaissance plane standing by at Ben Becula. If a trawler or any kind of boat shows up, you will alert the plane. They're standing by on your frequency. Call sign is Starfish to aircraft.
Yes, sir.
If signals are made and a trawler gets into position, alert the aircraft and it'll fly in, drop flares and take photographs, and scare the trawler off. And then we will deal with the people on the island. I want no one, and I mean no one, to leave before I arrive.
How are you getting to the island, sir?
I'll take the 2nd boat and the 4 spare men.
The islands are very tricky, sir. If no one can pilot you there in the dark...
Well, I have, sir. I'd get my cousin David McNeil to take you. He could do it blindfold.
Thank you again, Mr. MacLeod. What time does it get dark?
About 9 o'clock, sir. I think I should get the bigger boat moving about 8 o'clock. We'll be running against a heavy tide.
Well, let's meet here at 7. Major Williams, I'd like to inspect the men you've chosen.
We'll see you at 7 then, sir.
Yes.
Come on in. Well, it's quiet today, isn't it?
Aye. Have you been waiting, gentlemen? What'll you be drinking?
Oh, 2 whiskies, please. I was saying, the hotel is very quiet today, Mr. Macaulay.
Aye, they're all away at the fishing. It's not unusual on a day like this. There you are, Mr. Nicholson. How is Mr. Grant? Oh, there's the phone. Excuse me.
How is Mr. Grant, he says.
Yes. Have you seen your cousin?
Davy, yes, I've spoken to him. He'll keep quiet and take the boat over. I got a bit of news from him. That big boat, the Orancy, the one the colonel bought.
Well?
Well, it was stolen this afternoon while we were down at the camp.
From the harbour?
Aye. By a lad who looked like that foreign sailor and another man helping him. They sailed it north. And there were others aboard as well, they say.
Where's the colonel?
Well, he was down at the harbour, kicking up hail, so Davy said. And the girl was there as well, so that leaves them out.
How do you mean?
Well, they're marooned here. They can't get anywhere.
Oh, that's true.
Do you want to see her?
No, not now. We should be at the camp soon.
Aye, I'll have to pick up Davy. I'll meet you in front in 5 minutes.
Right. All on board, Mr. MacLeod. We can get going.
Aye. Major, make them keep their heads down.
We'll get this sorted out between us. Now, when we land there, you'll take in MacLeod, a corporal, and 10 men and go to the signal post. You'd better take a good look at the map while it's still light.
Right, it'll get us there.
I'll take the sergeant and the other 10 and make a search of the west shore to see that the beaches are empty. When you've dealt with the signal post, we'll meet at the old ruined house, the Morrison Croft, I think you said, Mr. McLaren?
Aye, that's right.
Now, let's work our route out across the island.
This is as far as we dare go in daylight, Major.
Where is the island?
Just behind that headland. It'll take us about half an hour when the light goes.
All right. We'll anchor here.
Here we are, Dr. Lawrence. I'm afraid it's rather gloomy inside. But this is where we must wait until they come for you.
Mr. Swanson, there are people in here.
Don't be alarmed. They'll remain quiet. They won't disturb you. Anyway, there are two rooms. Come into the other one and we can talk. You can be by yourself here.
These people do disturb me, Swanson. I had hoped to be going alone.
Circumstances have changed, Doctor.
I was promised I'd be taken away safely.
And so you shall be. But we have to clean up after you. These people were all part of the network, unknown to you, but necessary to you. They have to be saved, too.
There are women out there.
7 people in all, 3 of them women. Would you like to meet them?
No.
Your instructions to leave London, a phone call, I believe, a woman's voice.
Yes.
The woman who looked after your safety in London saw that you weren't followed, that you were never in danger. A Miss Thornton. Would you like to meet her?
No.
Miss Thornton.
Yes, Mr. Swanson?
When is the call scheduled to the trawler?
In 2 minutes.
Thank you. You can go back to the others. You never saw her, but she saw you every day. So we must send her away, too. It's the same with the others. We're clearing the ground.
What are you doing?
Calling the trawlers to tell them everyone is now here, waiting to be taken off. And there's an extra passenger. Your friend from London.
Is he going?
I think it's safest. He'll be company for you.
Hmm.
And don't worry. You'll be away before anyone can stop us. They'll be here as soon as it's dark.
All right, Ian?
The island is straight ahead. I'm taking you in now. There's a boat there already. I'll put in alongside it.
It's the Orange Say, all right.
Sergeant?
Sir?
Leave 2 men to guard the boats. The others come ashore.
Sir?
Jim?
Yes, sir.
This is where we split up. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. And to you. Lead the way, Ian.
Aye, right.
Corporal.
Sure.
Get your men together and keep close.
There's the old house, Jim.
Ah, yes. Let's have the glasses. There's a light on in the house. I can just see a gleam through the thatch. Here, take a look.
And I think the door's opening. Ah, did you see that? There's a guard in the door. It's that foreign sailor.
Keep an eye on him.
I can hear something from the sea. It's a trawler coming in.
Where?
There, north of west.
So it is. Starfish to aircraft.
Aircraft listening.
There is a trawler coming in on the west shore.
I'm on my way. I'll be there when you need me. Out.
Jim. The guard on the door, the sailor, he's armed. And the trawler's signaling.
Ian, any minute we'll have them all over the moor. Get the corporal and his men up here.
I will.
Starfish to aircraft. The trawler is signaling. Can you see her?
I can see her, chum.
Would you hold off for a minute? I've something to do.
I can wait. I'll take a line on her.
Thanks.
Jim! Jim, they're here.
Corporal, there's an armed guard on that door down there. Can you put him out of action, silently?
Denin and I can do it, sir.
Do it, then.
Come on, Denin.
The trawler's still signaling.
Yes, I've been trying to translate.
It'll be in some special code. Keep your eye skinned for the corporal and Denning. I've lost them.
There they are now. Just by the corner of the croft.
Ah, yes. Any minute now.
They've got him.
Starfish to aircraft. Go in now.
Look at those flares. It's like daylight.
The trawler's turning away.
Don't bother about the trawler now. Down to that house, men. Corporal, cover me as I go in.
What is this?
Look at them, sir. It's like a railway waiting room. Just waiting to go.
Don't shoot. Please don't shoot.
Then get your hands up. All of you. Leave your bags where they are. Get back against the wall. 2, 4, 6, 7. Corporal.
Yeah?
Take the four men over there. The three women... Stop her.
Stay against the wall.
Search them.
Sir. Denning, you take the...
The Major's here, sir. How are things going, Jim?
Well, we've caught seven of them.
Oh, Major Williams, there are two men in a small room over here, sir.
Two more, eh? Bring them out here, Corporal.
Sir.
Good evening, Major Williams.
Mr. Hammond.
I'm glad you got here in time, Major. I was beginning to be worried.
I didn't expect you, sir.
The Brigadier was taking no chances. If you didn't get here in time, I was to go on with this lot to the trawler and behind the curtain. I didn't fancy it.
I should think not. Is this Dr. Lawrence with you?
No, this is Mr. Eric Swanson, the organizer. Sorry, Swanson, when you get into this game, you meet some strange companions. You never know who to trust.
Oh, this is Captain Nicholson and Mr. Hammond from the department in London.
I'm delighted to see you, Captain.
Mr. Hammond, you have a radio here.
Swanson was talking to the trawler when your aircraft rudely interrupted him.
I see. Major Williams, everything's under control here. I think one of us should contact the Brigadier. He'll want to see these people.
Right, I'll go. I'll take the sergeant and two men. Sergeant?
Sir.
Captain, we should get these people away from here as quickly as possible. These trawlers won't give up so easily.
We are staying here until the Brigadier arrives, sir.
I'm advising you, Captain. Ordering you.
The Brigadier's orders are different, sir. What are you doing here anyway? The Brigadier didn't say anything about it.
He wouldn't, would he? I was here in case you failed. Captain, it is dangerous to stay here. Believe me, get going.
Everyone found in this house stays here. Brigadier's orders. And I am going to search you, sir.
If you hadn't arrived, Captain, I volunteered to go down the escape line for the department. So what do you expect to find? Money? False passport? Revolver?
I'll take the revolver.
I'm going to find the Brigadier.
You are staying here.
What's the matter, Captain? Are you after Grant's job?
No, sir. I'm just trying to finish it for him. Only a friend could have got so close to Grant.
You're being insolent.
No, sir. Obedient. Everyone stays till the Brigadier arrives.
I am the Brigadier's aide. I'm going to warn him.
Mr. Hammond. It's dark out there. And it's a big island. Sentries have been posted with orders to challenge anyone who tries to leave this building. If any such person does not return to it immediately, they are to shoot.
Withdraw the order.
No, sir.
Captain, I have been longer in this business than you. I know when a man is bluffing.
You must have a very good reason for leaving, sir. I've warned you.
I'm going down to the bay.
shame. Why did you do that?
I warned him, Ian.
I shot him, sir. And the brigadier's here.
Captain Nicholson.
Sir.
Why did you let Hammond leave?
I didn't, sir. I ordered him to stay until you came. Did you know he was here, sir?
No. No, I didn't. Who are these people?
One of them is Dr. Lawrence, and that's Swanson. He's the organizer, sir.
Seven, eight people.
About Hammond, I think he was the man Grant saw.
I'm sure of it. It's a pity you let him make a run for it, but it may have saved us a great deal of trouble. We can get what we want from Swanson and Lawrence.
I'm having them all searched.
It's been a very successful operation, Nicholson, and a very necessary success. Well done.
Thank you, sir. I think the trawler's calling.
Leave that to the Navy. Get all these people in the boats, will you?
Right, sir.
In the final episode of The Dark Island by Robert Barr, Jim Nicholson was played by Edward D'Souza, Ian MacLeod by Bryden Murdoch, Major Williams, Peter Hawkins, the Brigadier, Michael Kilgariff, George Hammond, Kim Grant, and Dr. Lawrence by Roy Spencer. The Dark Island was produced for the BBC by Peter Titheridge.